2 over z squared minus 4 plus 10 over 6z plus 12 equals 1 over z minus 2. So I know what it's equal to. It's an expression, but I still have it's equal to something. Okay, now, if I have that equal sign, I do not need to get common denominators. I can actually times away my denominators, okay? But I don't want to overcompensate. I don't want to times by z squared minus 4 and 6z plus 12 and z minus 2. Because if I times by all of those, I'm going to get a z to the power of 4 and I can't solve those. So the first step you have to do is going to be the first step we always do, which is factor. And so we're just going to factor our denominators. Okay, so 2 over z minus 2, whoops, and z plus 2. That one's difference of squares. Factor this one. What's the greatest common factor of that second denominator? 6. And you would have left a z plus 2. And then this one's already factored, a z minus 2. So you do still need to factor your denominators, which is great, because every single section we did, 6.1, 2, 3, and now 4, we always factor the denominators. Okay, now, I can multiply to get away, get my denominators to go away, because I have the equal sign. So how do I get a z minus 2 to go away? I times by a z minus 2. I don't need to do it on the top and bottom. Okay, I don't need to do it on the top and bottom. I want to go back to that one that I wrote down here. When I tried to go from here up to this one, I did not times the top and bottom by 3 for each of these fractions. I only times everything by a 3, or in other words, by a 3 over 1. I tripled every piece of my equation. So not top and bottom on these ones, which makes it a little bit easier. But I do have to do the same thing. If I was timesing this piece by 3, then I have times this one by 3 and this one by 3. So on this one, if I times this first item by z minus 2, or the last item, I guess, I have times this one by z minus 2, and F times this one by z minus 2. Okay? Now I cancel as I go along. I was using this z minus 2 to cancel with this one, so I got rid of that fraction. Okay? But it also got rid of another one, another factor over here. You see how I got rid of that one? So if I would have not factored it, I probably would have overcompensated there. Okay, what other fraction, or what other factor in my denominator do I want to get rid of? Z plus 2. So I'm going to put a z plus 2 beside each one. Okay? What else is in the denominator that I need to factor or cancel? The 6. So I can put a 6 on each of these two. Okay? Now, go ahead and cancel what cancels. So in this first section, the z minus 2s cancel. But you see how the 6 doesn't. So what do I have left here is 2 times 6, which is 12. Okay, let's look at the second one. The z plus 2 is cancelled and the 6 cancelled. So what am I left with? Plus 10 and the z minus 2. You see how that one would be? Okay. Equal sign stays where the equal sign is. What's left over there is a 1 times by z plus 2. Well, that's with z plus 2. Now, this is just a linear statement that we have to solve. And you've done this before. Distribute. So I have 12 plus 10z minus 20 equals z plus 2. I just have to get all my z's together on one side. Did I make a mistake?
6.
Where did the 6 go? Oh, thank you. This one has a 6 here. Okay, so then I lied. What's this going to be? 6z plus 12. Thanks for catching that. Am I right now? Yes? Okay, good. And again, like I said, though, we can solve all this. We just have to get all our z's to one side. So I'm going to minus 6z off here so that over on this side I have 4z. And what number did I have? I had 12 minus 20. I had a negative 8. Okay, and so now I can add my 8 over to the other side. So I have 4z equals 20. And then I divide by 4 on both sides. So I get z equals 5. You do need to verify on each one of these. Okay, so you do need to verify because z minus, or 5, could have been a non-permissible value. And it wasn't in this case, but you do want to make sure that you verify. Okay, so here's this answer. Because z could not be, and if we go back up to the beginning, z couldn't be plus or minus 2. Those are the only ones. Okay, which is good. So then now we go, okay, well, it's not one of my non-permissible values, so then I should verify it by subbing it back in.